After seven properties that we have discussed in the lecture, the previous lecture, now coming to the eighth one, that is time integration property. Here the Fourier transform of integral of minus infinity to t x of tau d tau is given by 1 by j omega into x of j omega. See, it is x of j omega, not omega, right? And that is if x of 0 is 0, okay, that is capital X of 0 equals to 0. Then convolution property, very important, very much useful application for solving too much typical problems is this convolution property, because the convolution in time domain is going to become just multiplication in frequency domain in Fourier transform, right? How useful it is, you know how difficult it is to calculate the convolution, but if you use the application of this Fourier transform and with this property, you can just multiply the frequency domain terms, that is Fourier transforms of both the signals, and if you just inverse it, you will get this convolution. Super, right? Then multiplication property, that is x1 of t into x2 of t is going to give convolution in frequency domain, like opposite, and but divided by 2 pi, that is important. Then duality property is going to give you, that means if x of t Fourier transform is x of omega, that is capital X of omega, then you replace that omega with time domain t. What happens? Then the time domain function will be capital X of t, and its Fourier transform is going to become 2 pi into small x of minus omega. Too much variation, right? You are getting 2 pi multiplication factor, that is okay, and you are getting minus omega replace it with time, we need to replace the time in x of t with minus omega, not omega, right? Then coming to the modulation property, here in this modulation property, x of t into cos omega ct, okay, that means you have x of t whose Fourier transform is x of omega, and if it got multiplied with cos omega ct, you will get Fourier transform half into capital X of omega minus omega c plus capital X into omega plus omega c. So you just note down all these relations and you try to solve the problems in Fourier transform, then only you can be able to solve the questions in exam. Otherwise you just going through this will not help you, but you need to know all this, that's what I'm saying here, right? Then conjugation property is that x conjugate of t Fourier transform is x conjugate of minus omega, right? And Parseval's relation is saying this thing, that is integral minus infinity to infinity x1 of t into x2 star t is nothing but 1 divided by 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity x1 of omega into x2 star of omega d omega. You can compare this with the Fourier series Parseval's also. That means all these Parseval's modulation conjugation are of related to the conjugation only. Okay. And here the energy is given by integral minus infinity to infinity x of t whole square dt equals to 1 divided by 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity x of omega whole square modulus. Very important, man. They will ask you to calculate the energy by using Parseval's theorem. They may not mention Parseval's theorem also, but it will become very easy if you just find its Fourier transform and you just do integration and divided by 2 pi, you will get it. Thank you.